Are you aware that the National Aeronautical Space Administration had declared that Sanskrit is the ideal language of artificial intelligence because of its structure? Don't bother if you haven't heard about this, because this is simply a rumor. NASA hasn't declared anything of that sort. However, Sanskrit is indeed a language that can be used for data protection. It has already been used for data protection for thousands of years since its conception. Sanskrit, Girvanavani or Devavani, it is considered to be one of the oldest languages of India. The myriad of Vedic literature has been composed in Sanskrit. In the next few minutes, we are going to learn about Sanskrit prosody and how it can be used for data protection. Sanskrit prosody or chandas refer to one of the six Vedangas or the limbs of Vedic studies. It is the study of poetic meters and verse in Sanskrit. The ancient manuals on chandas include Pingala's Chanda Sutra, while an example of a medieval Sanskrit prosody is Kedar Bhatta's Vritta Ratnakara. The most exhaustive compilations of Sanskrit prosody describe over 600 meters. This is a substantially large repertoire than any other metrical condition. The Chanda means pleasing or alluring. The Rigveda includes the names of the meters and hence the origin of the Chandas, which can be dated to 2nd millennium BC. The ancient Chanda Sutras of Pingala, also called Pingala Sutras, is the oldest Sanskrit prosody text that has survived into the modern age, and it is dated to between 600 and 200 BCE. Chapters 328 to 335 of the Agni Puran, Chapter 15 of the Natya Shastra, Chapter 104 of the Brihat Samhita, the Pramoda Janaka section of Manasolasa contain embedded treatises on Chandas. Let's try to understand the basic terms before we proceed to Chandas. An Akshara or a syllable in Sanskrit prosody is a vowel following one or more consonants, or a vowel without any consonants. A shloka is defined in Sanskrit prosody as a group of four quarters or padas. Indian prosody studies recognize two types of stanzas. Vritta stanzas are those that have a precise number of syllables, while jati stanzas are those that are based on syllabic time lengths, that is a matra. It can contain varying numbers of syllables. The vritta stanzas have three forms: samavritta, where the four quarters are similar in pattern; ardha samavritta, where alternate verses have a similar syllabic structures; and vishamavritta, where all four quarters are different. The meters found in classical Sanskrit poetry are sometimes alternately classified into three kinds. Aksharavritta is the meter that depends on the number of syllables in a verse, with relative freedom in the distribution of light and heavy syllables. This style is derived from the older Vedic forms and found in the great epics, the Mahabharata and the Ramayana. Varnavritta is the meter that depends on syllable count, but the light heavy patterns are fixed. Matravritta is the meter that depends on the duration, where each verse line has a fixed number of matra, usually grouped in sets of four. Gana is the technical term for the pattern of light and heavy syllables in a sequence of three. It is used in treatises on Sanskrit prosody to describe meters according to a method first propounded in Pingala's Chanda Sutras. Pingala organizes the meters into two units, a light syllable called Laghu and a heavy syllable called Guru. Pingala's method described any meter as a sequence of ganas or triplets of syllables. Now let's come to the seven major chandas or meters of Sanskrit prosody. The simplest text of Vedic literature is the Sandhya. A verse in Sandhya mentions the seven types of chandas as follows: Gayatrishnaganushtap, Brihate Pankritrishtap, Jagatyaschandamsi. The 3-8 syllable Gayatri, the 4-8 syllable Anushtap, the 4-11 syllable Trishtap, the 4-12 syllable Jagati, and the mixed pada meters named Ushne, Brihati, and Pankti. It means that a particular verse written in Gayatri Chanda will consist of only 24 syllables. Anything more or less than 24 would imply that the shloka is not the original one and has either been manipulated or it is being recited incorrectly. For example, the Gayatri Mantra is written in Gayatri Chanda and it has exactly 24 syllables. So let's try to count them. Tat, Sa, Vi, Tur, Va, Re, Ni, Yam, Bhar, Go, De, Va, Sya, Di, Ma, Hi, Di, Yo, Yo, Na, Pra, Cho, Da, Ya. The Gayatri Chanda is found in fundamental Vedic texts like Rigveda and Atharvaveda. Ushne is the second chanda found in Vedic texts, but it is not used as frequently as Gayatri. The Anushtup Chanda is most frequently used in post-Vedic Sanskrit metrical literature, embedded in the Bhagavad Gita, the Mahabharata, the Ramayana, the Puranas, Smritis, and scientific treatises. The Trishtup Chanda is second in frequency in post-Vedic Sanskrit metrical literature, dramas, plays, parts of the Mahabharata, and major first millennium kavyas. Beyond these 7 meters, ancient and medieval era Sanskrit scholars developed numerous other syllable-based meters, like for example, Ati Jagati, Shakavari, Ati Shakavari, Ashti, Atyashti, Dhruti, Ati Dhruti, Kruti, and so on. Hindu scholars developed Gana Chandas, that is meters based on matras, like Arya, Udgiti, Upagiti, Giti, and Aryagiti. The entire Sankhyarika text of the Sankhya school of Hindu philosophy is composed in Arya meter, as are many chapters in the mathematical treatises of Aryabhata and some texts of Kalidas. The attempt to identify the most pleasing sounds and perfect compositions led ancient Indian scholars to study permutations and combinatorial methods of enumerating musical meters. The chandas can be used to identify corrupt texts and manipulations. Significant changes in meter, wherein the meter of the succeeding sections returns to the earlier sections, are sometimes thought to be an indication of later interpolations and insertion of the text into a Sanskrit manuscript. Like for example, it is being revealed that the most controversial text of Manusmriti has been tampered and manipulated, as is evident from the deviation of the texts from the original chandas. Some of the chandas are of the older period, implying that they refer to the original text, while a majority of verses from Manusmriti represent a deviation from these older chandas, indicating that they have been manipulated or changed over a period of years. The 11th century Ratnakara Shanti's Chando Ratnakara describes algorithms to enumerate binomial combinations of meters through pratyaya. The 6 pratyaya were as follows: Prastara, which was a procedure for enumerating all meters of the given length; Nashta, which was a procedure for finding a meter given its position in the table; Uddishta is a procedure for finding the position in the table of a given meter; Laghukriya is a calculation of the number of meters in the table containing a given number of laghu syllables; Sankhya is a calculation of the total number of meters in the table; Adhvana is a calculation of the space needed to write down the prastara table of a given class. The Pingala Sutras include a discussion of rules of the binary system to calculate permutations of Vedic meters. Pingala developed the art of Matrameru, which is the field of counting sequences such as 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8. But wait a minute, you know this number, right? This is nothing but the Fibonacci sequence itself. It was introduced by Leonardo Bonacci to the Western European mathematics in the late 12th century AD, but it was invented by Pingala in 200 BC. Similarly, the 10th century Halayudha's commentary on Pingala Sutras developed Meru Prastara, which we today know as the Pascal's triangle. But Halayudha had developed it centuries before Pascal. Unfortunately, our education system teaches us about Fibonacci and Pascal and not about Pingala and Halayudha. UNESCO proclaimed the tradition of Vedic chant and prosody a masterpiece of the oral and intangible heritage of humanity on November 7, 2008. So let's take a step forward in understanding our own culture and the rich heritage. If you found our research informative, then follow our page Satyalok on Instagram and help us to spread the greatness of ancient India with as many people as we can. Stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.